Hello friends, in this lecture we will start with the machine learning. So the basic thing is, what is machine learning? So there are different paradigms which we can say comes under the machine learning, and there are various people who have researched on the machine learning. So this is one definition by Herbert Alexander Simon. And he defined the machine learning as, learning is any process by which a system improves performance from experience. Or machine learning is concerned with computer programs that automatically improves their performance through experience. So basically, in classical programming, what was there, if we consider C, C++ programming, so we have to give as an input to the programming language that we have to define some rules for it, and we have to provide the data for it, and we will be getting some answer for the same. So this is the classical method of programming. But now in machine learning, instead of giving data and rules as an input, we are giving data and answers as an input. And for that, there are some algorithms which will define the rules for us for any particular problem. So this is the basically machine learning. We will see one by one. It is actually trained rather than explicitly programmed. Means, suppose we are having or we are considering a thing where we have to add two numbers. So before machine learning, what we were doing is, we are giving two numbers to the machine and we were defining the process of addition, and machine will add two numbers and it will produce the output for us. Now the thing is, we have to give the data, like we are going to add two numbers, and we have to give the answer to the machine that, suppose my numbers are 10 and 20. So I'm giving the values 10 and 20 as a data, as an input to the machine or algorithm, and answer as a 30 to the algorithm. And what we have to do is, we have to generate the rules to add these two numbers. The rules might be, you can consider these variables as A and B. Someone can consider M1, M2. Someone can consider X and Y as a numbers. So these are some rules we can say. Now, the thing is, these all the things are trained rather than explicitly programmed. Like we were programming in C to add two numbers, but here we have to train the data such a way that it will add two numbers by its own way. So for this, we are having some algorithms in machine learning, and some things or some type of data are there. So we will be going to see all these things in detail one by one. Next is, why machine learning? Because to solve any problem on a computer, we need an algorithm. An algorithm is a sequence of instructions that should be carried out to transform the input to output. Like we were having some sorting algorithms, we were having some searching algorithms. And for any task, there may be various algorithms. Like suppose we are performing sorting, so there are different types of sorting algorithms are present. Like bubble sort is there, heap sort is there, merge sort is there. Everyone's input and output is same, but the algorithm it performs is different for everything. Now for the same task, there may be various algorithms, and we may be interested to finding the most efficient one, like which algorithm gives us least number of instructions, and or it may uses small amount of memory, or any algorithm which can perform both the tasks. Like for some tasks, we do not have an algorithm. For some tasks, there are no algorithms, just we have to perform the things, where we have to check whether the whether or what the time actually it requires, or what energy it requires. All these things are there. So by considering all these things, what we have to decide is, we have to choose such a path or such a procedure which will be having less complexity and a more efficient output for the same. So why machine learning is to develop such a systems that are too difficult or expensive to construct manually, because they require specific detailed skill or knowledge turned to a specific task, or to develop systems that can automatically adopt or customize themselves to individual users. To discover new knowledge from large databases, which is also known as data mining, and ability to do such tasks which require some intelligence. So we can easily compile thousands of examples, messages, some of which we know, some of which we don't know, or we would like to like the computer to extract automatically the algorithm for the task. So to deal with all such problems, we need machine learning, because every time it is not possible to go manually, write algorithm for everything and provide the input to the algorithm, produce the output from the algorithm. So this is very, we can say, traditional or classical type of programming. So we have to go beyond this. For the same purpose, machine should be intelligent, or machine should work on large databases, machine should adopt the things automatically. For all these things, we can go for the machine learning. Next is, there is a huge area of machine learning. So with regard to applications, for every application, there is a broad area or large number of things we can perform under these applications. So the thing is, data mining is the thing, first application of machine learning, where we can say daily large amount of data is producing, and what we have to do is we have to extract the information from the data. Like, data is the raw material which we can collect from anything, but the information is the thing which you can sort from the data, which will be helpful for you. So daily a large amount of data is producing, and we have to extract the information from it. We have to convert these large databases into small databases. We have to upgrade the databases. We have to keep the records into the databases. We have to retrieve through it whenever user wants. So all these things comes under data mining. So it is every time it is not possible that we should go for any database system, or where we can do the things traditionally, like you are firing some queries and you will be getting the answer. So this is not possible every time. So we can go for the data mining. By using machine learning, there are some algorithms which can give us the answers within a fraction of a second and all the things. Next is the finance, where most the point of sale terminals record the details of each transactions, date, customers identification code, goods, budgets, and their amount. So all these things comes under this, in which we have to maintain the records of various number of activities performed by the customer. So it will be possible with the machine learning. Next is manufacturing. In this large amount of data is going to manufacture, or suppose any product you are manufacturing, so related to that manufacturing, that product, you need to generate the data for the same. You have to keep the record, you have to track the record. For all these things, you can go for the machine learning. Next is medicine. So this is the health kind of issue, where you can do like learning programs are used for medical diagnosis. Lots of types of diseases are there. So by collecting the data from the patient, you can directly diagnose what the disease he is having, or what are the prevention measures he have to take. All these things that comes under machine learning. In telecommunication, call patterns are analyzed for network optimization and maximizing the quality of service. Next is science, where we can go for the large amount of data in physics, astronomy, and biology can only be analyzed fast enough by computers. Next is, the World Wide Web is huge, and it is constantly growing and searching for relevant information, and it cannot be done manually. So we can go for the machine learning because there are various types of algorithms are there, and to be intelligent, a system that is a changing environment should have the ability to learn. And in machine learning, yes, it is possible. So we have to go for the machine learning. So these are some applications of machine learning. Next is the thing where in this diagram, you can see where the machine learning is actually. So the artificial intelligence is the main area, we can say, under which machine learning comes, and in that deep learning comes. So basically the artificial intelligence was born in 1950s. And after that, it started that whether machine can work intellectually or machine can think, or if we are firing any question to the machine, whether the machine is allowed to answer, or whether the machine is able to answer. So with this with answers of this, machine learning evolved, and various algorithms evolved, and algorithms are intelligent enough to find out the answers, whatever the questions you are firing, and for what purpose you have designed the algorithm, that purpose is fulfilling by these algorithms. And under this comes deep learning. Again, it's a broad area, deep learning, under which there are some algorithms again, and it has its own path, it has its own advantage into it. So machine learning is not just a database problem, it is a part of artificial intelligence. So we cannot consider that only data mining or database handling things comes under machine learning. So machine learning is a very broad area, and number of things are possible by using this machine learning. So machine learning is a programming computers to optimize the performance criterion using example data or past experience. Like before some time I told you that we have to give the input as a data and answers, and by using this machine will generate the rule to give the answers for the same. So how this is possible? So by using the example data you are providing, or the past experience that algorithm got before this, so it will collect the data, it will check with it, and accordingly it will produce the output to us. So we have a model defined up to some parameters, and learning is the execution of computer program to optimize the parameters of the model using the training data or past experience. So how these things happens, or whether actually these things happen, you will be getting one by one when we start our algorithms. At that time, you will get to know how it is possible. The model may be predictive to make predictions in the future, or descriptive to gain the knowledge from data, or both. So we are having some models into it or algorithms into it that are either predictive or descriptive. Predictive in the sense learning algorithm have to predict something it will happen like this. So these things we can say as a prediction. The second one is a descriptive, where it will learn from the past experiences it have got from the before when it executed. Okay. So by this, Tom Mitchell is a person who is a researcher in machine learning and have invented various things in machine learning. So he have defined, or he have given, a formal definition of machine learning. So the definition is, a computer program is said to learn from experience A with respect to some class of tasks T and performance measures P. If its performance at task T as measured by P improves with experience E. So this is the terminology used. What we have to do is, we have to measure the performance of any algorithm, and that measure is known as a P. This performance is measured with the tasks. Tasks are known as a T. And this task works on the experience before this he have got. So that experience is measured with E. So these are the terminologies used into the definition of machine learning. So every machine learning algorithm works on this definition only. Next thing is advantages of machine learning. So there are some advantages. Various advantages are there. We are listing some over there. So first is accurate. So machine learning uses data to discover the optimal decision-making engine for your problem. as you collect more data, the accuracy can increase automatically, because actually it works on the experience. So how much data you are providing, so if you are providing large amount of data, means the accuracy will going to increase automatically. Next is, algorithms are automated, means as answers are validated or discarded, the machine learning model can learn new patterns automatically. So this allows users to embed machine learning directly into the automated workflow, because all the learning algorithms are automated. It learns automatically by the past experiences. These algorithms are fast, can generate answers within a fraction of seconds or milliseconds as you new data streams in, allowing systems to react in real time. Next one is customizable. Many data-driven problems can be addressed with machine learning, and machine learning models are custom built from your own data. It can be configured to optimize whatever drives your business. Next is scalable. As your business grows, machine learning easily scales to handle increased data rates, and some machine learning algorithms can scale to handle large amount of data on many machines in the cloud, because it is not limited only for any single database or the thing. We can go for the cloud also. So now the various applications are there where we can use machine learning along with the IoT, and whatever the data is going to generate, we can save the data onto the cloud only, and we have to perform the operations onto the cloud. In medicine also, we can say machine learning diagnose diseases, and there are some symptoms we can give as an input, lab measurements and DNA test, etc. So this is also, or medicine or medical also, broad area, or there are lots of advantages with medicines also in machine learning. Machines are, by using machine learning, we can say that machines are enough intelligent to find out the answers within a milliseconds, and it can provide us so that it will reduce the human efforts, and we can get accurate results for the same. Thank you.